If you break down the term bronchiectasis, it literally means bronchial dilation. This makes perfect sense because bronchiectasis is a disease characterized by airways that have become abnormally distended. This causes the classic SHIT clinical features. This stands for excessive sputum production, hemoptysis, recurrent infections, and a tenacious cough that just won't go away. The pathogenesis of this bronchial dilation is based on chronic inflammation, which is triggered by pathogens colonizing the airways. This leads to increased mucus production and bronchial damage, which serves as a great nidus for further infections. Consequently, a vicious cycle ensues where infection causes airway damage and inflammation, which causes further infection. However, there is often an underlying etiology which can induce the disease itself. Some key causes can be remembered by the AABBCC acronym. This stands for alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency, asthma, bacterial infections, bronchial obstruction from foreign bodies, cystic fibrosis, and COPD. Now let's move on and break down the clinical features of this SHIT disease. Excessive sputum production is a cornerstone feature. Mucopurulent secretions are present in 2/3 of patients and is usually produced daily. Hemoptysis is typically mild and affects 50% of patients. However, a massive bleed is a life-threatening complication to be aware of. Infective exacerbations are characterized by 3 changes. Firstly, increased sputum volume. Secondly, increased sputum purulence. And thirdly, increased cough. The tenacious cough itself is chronic. It's present in most patients for most days of the week and often worse when lying flat or on the side. Just quickly, another key feature that you can look for is clubbing when physically examining a patient's fingers. For the investigation of bronchiectasis, I want you to remember just one thing. High-resolution CT is the absolute gold standard for diagnosis. The key finding here is a bronchial diameter which exceeds that of the adjacent vessel. This is often described as an increased bronchoarterial ratio, which objectively demonstrates abnormal dilation, as you can kind of see here. Finally, management is needed to help in 4 domains. Although hemoptysis is common, massive bleeding requires urgent transfer to hospital. Bronchial artery embolization or lobectomy may be required. Infective exacerbations can be managed with antibiotics as per local guidelines. Long-term therapy using macrolides is appropriate if patients have more than 3 exacerbations per year. Moreover, steroids and bronchodilators aren't really helpful unless the patient has other indications for them. Lifestyle optimization includes helping people with smoking cessation, reducing alcohol intake, providing immunizations, and managing comorbidities. Finally, pulmonary rehabilitation through exercise can help with reducing breathlessness. Additionally, airway clearance can be assisted using physical techniques and nebulized mucolytic agents. Let's quickly summarize with our mnemonics. Bronchiectasis presents as an SHIT disease with sputum, hemoptysis, recurrent infections, and a tenacious cough. But we can help by managing hemoptysis, exacerbations, lifestyle optimization, and pulmonary rehabilitation. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.